Sunday morning, and that was my only service. I was supposed to come back. And before I left, I got an email from a church in Baltimore. It said, "We see you're going to be preaching in D.C. Just come on over and preach for us." Never heard of the church. I said, "Okay." Accepted the invitation. Had a friend of mine that was a graduate of the Bible College, a young African American that had lived in Baltimore. And he called me and said he took a drive over to be in the service and watch it. I said, "Hey, can you take me to this church?" He said, "Oh yeah, no problem." So he drove me, he knew the church. He didn't never been there, didn't know that much about it, but he knew where it was, knew big churches. Sure enough, when we drove up that place, there was coffee. We're looking for a place to park, and I remember telling him, when I'm looking around the people walking in, I said, "Oh no." He said, "What do you mean?" I said, "This is not a Pentecostal program." He said, "Well, how can you tell?" I said, "Just look at their faces." I said, "Oh no, this is not a Pentecostal church." So we walked in.
You don't remember that shit?
Your object of faith is right. minds, then the Holy Spirit is subject to you. If your object is correct, this Holy Spirit has something to do. A television. Is your faith? Does Christ and Him crucified have His proper place in your heart? Father, in the name of Jesus, as we close this service today, I thank You, first of all, for these people in this sanctuary. They've been here through thick and thin. They've been here the good times and they've been here the bad times. They've remained faithful to the sacrifice of Christ. And I thank You for that. But Lord, in these last days, there's going to be strong delusion that comes into the church. And Lord, I don't want to see a single person, whether in the sanctuary or those that are watching, wherever in the world they may be watching. I don't want to see them be deceived. And Lord, I'm praying. Right now, I'm asking for the help of the Holy Spirit that every person under the sound of my voice, that their object of faith is correct. Their object of faith is Jesus Christ and the source by which we have all of the benefits. The means is the cross of Christ. May we ever keep the cross of Christ foremost in our heart and in our life. Help us never to forget that every single thing that we have that is good in our life is only because of what Jesus Christ did at Calvary's cross. May we never push it aside, but may it always have the preeminence in our heart and in our life, so that when that day comes and we stand before You, that everyone under the sound of my voice will hear the words of our Master when He says, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant." Start praising Him right now. Start praising Him right now. Start praising Him right now. Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus. Lord, I want to be faithful. 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 I want to be numbered faithful. I want to be counted faithful. I want my life to be faithful in every single aspect. Faithful in the morning. Faithful in the afternoon. Faithful in the evening. Faithful on the job. Faithful in the mall. Faithful when we come to church. Faithful, faithful, faithful. May You call us faithful brethren. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now give the Lord a big, big hand. Let's have one more word of prayer for the Bible Talk tomorrow. I want you to lift your hands. And I want us to join our faith together. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we, the body of Christ here at Family Worship Center, and those that are our media members and others that are watching through this screen, tomorrow as we come before the people to ask for their help for one of the greatest mission outreaches in the world today, the giving out of the expositor spoon. Lord, I'm asking that the Holy Spirit would go through those television waves into the homes of everyone that is watching, and that the Holy Spirit would begin to deal with their heart. And Lord, that we'll take care of the countries that You have laid before us this month. But especially, Lord, I'm asking that we'll get rid of those two countries right away so that we can move right on into the Democratic Republic of Congo. As we introduce that French edition of the Expositor Study Bible to a brand new audience, I'm asking You to speak to hearts, move upon hearts. Lord, move upon those that normally donated a Bible, move on up to donate two. Those that normally donated two, move upon them to donate four. Those that normally donated four, move upon them to donate eight. Move upon as many
the mirror of Jesus' life.
We love you, God.
Good luck. Don't he do it? Glory, thank you. It's a dying pastor, fine to say, and rightfully so. Glory, thank you. For me. Although I still don't want to be stuffed, this one did enough. Now dessert, well, I still don't want to be stuffed. I'll wait home for dessert.
Thank you. It's gotta be.
Lord, thank you. You can't move them on.
That's good. I don't know where they moved yet.
That is one of my favorites.
So you got plenty of favorites.
True.
But it claims to include sin and guilt.
Well, what else could it, right, Lord, if it don't include you?
No accidents from up there. It's
pure evil.
That's even Grandma G. Dope.
That's the only reason they're there, for a dope check.
No place to stay.
see him coming here running? I want to move. How much sense does that make me move? Then I'm the one being evil doing the disturbance. They don't need to move anything to be put out. Over a year ago. On the threats alone when she started quitting me. On the property and all. She was like, wait a minute, I can't let them videos go up. I'm not saying anything. Except I think I'm being videoed. Then come back and do this mess. This is a form of harassment too. Look at all the videos I have. Lord, thank you, that was enough for me to know I'm poor. But I'm not stuck.
Yeah.
It spoke of justification of faith. Number two, make it plain upon tables. This gospel message, so important it was, must be clear and easy to read. Number three, that he may run the reason. In essence, the Lord is saying that while situations in the near future are going to be difficult, victory is coming. Number four, for the vision is yet for the point of time. It was not in doubt. The time had already been set, and by the word of the Lord. In fact, the vision will be fulfilled in Christ, and more particularly, when we get to the new covenant,
from this. Thank God I don't smell they don't smoke or snore. If you know,
get up there.
Just act a fool. You don't know the difference because you're never over. So what you gonna miss if you never hear? Sit some mother on dope, grandma on dope. Really, I believe everybody should know.
Come and hang out with her. I'm calling her a friend of the Lord. Let them go. He was wobbling when she
got to do evil.
Thank you. lifestyle. The one we're thinking.
Thank you.
or rather what?
I claim Jesus.
The title song is a great song written by a rusty gentleman.